A key part of developer experience when working with Vue has always been its amazing set of developer tools. With the release of Vue 3.1, the Vue Compat build, more and more applications are migrating to Vue 3. And thankfully, the Vue 3 developer tools version is, at the moment of this recording, about ready to be fully released out of beta. So, if you haven't already tested the new Vue developer tools out, or you are looking for a quick rundown of the new changes and features, stay with me and let's dive right in. Getting access to the new developer tools is straightforward. Go to the Chrome Web Store and search for Vue DevTools. Choose the new one, add it to Chrome, and that's it. If you already have the older DevTools installed, they will both be active and may cause some odd behavior, so make sure to turn the old version off. For Firefox, head over to the official repository's changelog and under Assets, download the XPI file. The browser will prompt you to install the new tools. Go ahead and fire up a Vue 3 application, or even Vue 2 because it's also supported, and open up a Vue tab on the inspector panel on your web browser of choice. Likely one of the first things you're going to notice is that there's a new sleek design and the dropdown that says App 1. In browser pages with multiple Vue applications, for example, if we create two more Vue apps on the same page, wait for the DevTools to reload. You will be able to quickly swap between them and have the ability to inspect Vue apps that are inside of an iframe. The main area where we inspect our components, the inspector, is now found by selecting this compass-looking icon. When selecting one of your components, you'll see some icons over here. The first one that looks like an eye on a box indicates scroll to component. When clicking this icon, your browser will be scrolled to where the component is. The second one, indicated by the two less than greater than signs, means show render code. When you click this icon, you will be able to see the render function that is being used by the browser to render your component to the screen. Finally, the hamburger icon with the less than character is the one that I like the most. Inspect DOM. When you click this, your developer panel will automatically switch to the DOM inspector and highlight that component for you in the browser's DOM. No more digging through the infinite div soup. Another new change you may notice is that some components have the fragment pill label show on the right-hand side. This indicates that this component is a fragmented root component, commonly known as multi-root components. Next up is the performance pill. When you have a component in your application that is not performing very well because its rendering is slow, you will get a handy pill next to it, indicating the time it took to render or patch. If you hover over it, you'll see an extended tooltip with more information. Another new pill that you might see next to your components is the root indicator for router link components that are created with Vue Router. This new feature is extremely helpful when quickly inspecting your component tree to figure out how your navigation is set up. Curiously enough though, this feature is not directly added by the Vue tools themselves, but by Vue Router through the DevTools plugin system. One of the most exciting parts of the new Vue tools is that it comes fully ready to be integrated with external plugins. This means that library authors can now incorporate their libraries to have special panels, pills, and information displayed directly on your Vue developer tools. Two libraries that are already using this new system are Vuex and Vue Router. If you click under the Components dropdown, you will see a list of enabled plugins, indicated by the jigsaw piece throughout the tools. When clicking into one of these panels, you will see a custom view for that plugin. For example, the Vue Router panel shows us a list of our current available routes. If you are interested in creating your own plugins or reading about the process, the DevTools official docs now has a plugin development guide. On the right of the inspector icon, you will notice an icon that looks like a Brickbuster or Space Invaders. This is the new event timeline. And if you haven't interacted much with your application, you will see a blank central area with color-coded bullets on the left. Each of these color-coded lanes will display a timeline of events that your application is firing in real time. For example, if I click on one of my router link components, these dots appear on the right-hand side where the actual timeline is. This may not seem like much at first sight, but there's a lot of information packed in these little dots. If I click on the purple mouse events, a third panel on the very right will display more information. Not only was my click event registered, but also the mouse up and mouse down events that wrapped around that click. We even get the X and Y coordinates as captured by the mouse event. The blue circles in the router navigation lane include a lot more information, as it is an event customized by the Vue Router plugin. Component events will also display the full payload information. For example, this button will emit a custom event. If we click on the button, we should see the custom event showing up on the timeline with all the payload information. If you are getting overwhelmed by all the layers in the timeline, or are just dealing with an application with a lot of complexity, there is a helpful little button on the top right corner of the timeline area that allows us to turn off or turn back on individual layers of the timeline. I have saved one of my favorite features for last, the Open an Editor button. Let's first go back to the Inspector view. When you select one of your custom components, you will get an icon of a box and an arrow coming out of it on the far right. If you click this button, your editor will now open with the file that corresponds to that component. How cool is that? As I mentioned before, this will only work on your own custom components. So for example, if you click on this router view component, the Open in Editor button will not appear. It will only work on components like this About component or the App component. Please note that this works out of the box for Vue CLI, Nuxt, and the Quasar CLI projects. If you're working on a custom Webpack solution or Node.js, for example, you will need some extra setup. There's more on this on the documentation. This concludes our overview of the most notable new features of the new DevTools. There is a lot to unpack and explore here, so I highly recommend that you start using the tools as soon as possible and clicking around to discover all the little quality of life improvements that the DevTools team has added to this already amazing tool.